So, ja. So.
Okay,
Aber
today Imke Feldman is with us. Thanks a lot for joining us, Imke. Again, I would like to say I'm so sorry to everyone. There were some technical issues. We tried to figure it out. I think, let me check my computer as well. Yes, Imke, you are online now. Today, topic is some quality assurance tools for Power BI. Imke is gonna walk us through these tools that may help us build more stable and rigid models. We are listening to you, Imke. Thank you.
Thank you. Sorry as well about the technical issues. I had to restart my computer to be able to enter the team sessions. So sometimes it's really a bit tricky. Yeah, thanks for your patience as well. I have to reopen all my files because due to the restart of the computer, but I think I should be ready in a minute. So I'm sharing my screen and I hope you can see my slide now.
Yes, I do.
Excellent.
Audience should be able to see it as well.
Okay, thanks. Today I'm going to talk about some quality assurance tool for Power BI. But first, let me quickly introduce myself. Okay, so. For some reason, this virtual is not working. Here, sorry. My name is Imke Feldman. I work as a freelance BI consultant, and some of you might know me already or know at least my blog, thebiaccountant.com. There you find a lot of blog posts, mainly about Power Query, but basically all Power BI related stuff you can find there. I'm also fairly active in the forums, and if you are active on social media, you can follow me on Twitter or LinkedIn, or even check out my YouTube channel where I have some small videos as well. Today, the quality aspects I've structured them into basically the life cycle phases of a Power BI project during the initial development phase. Questions like, does my report return the correct results often pop up. Sometimes one wonders what the DAX measure does actually calculate, and want to understand more in detail what's going on in there. And another issue that might be worth checking is if actually subtotals add up correctly, because DAX doesn't have the concept of visual totals, but calculates every cell individually. So it can happen that you end up with results that look good on the detail level, but don't make sense on the subtotal or total level. So I'm going to show you how to efficiently check things like that as well. And then during adjustment phases, when you rework your model, then often questions can arise that if you're going to make a change in a certain measure, whether this will influence the depending measures and whether those will still deliver correct results. So this is also I will show some techniques that can be used for a question like that. And also, of course, doing regular refreshes if the numbers are still correct. And a special topic is during for audits and for documentation purposes, one often would like to understand which changes have been made to the model, because often financially critical decisions are being made based on Power BI reports and models. And of course, one has to often when the auditors come in, one has to be able to explain how the model works and if changes have been made compared to the last time the auditors have been there, for example. And therefore, I created three different tools. The first is the Power BI Buddy tool. That's designed to be as a Power BI workbook that should be open or should work as a companion tool workbook that you use with your main report file, for example. And then we have the Power BI Cleaner tool that helps you to identify columns and measures that are actually not used in your model and then therefore could be deleted in order to save model space. And the last one is the Power BI Comparer tool that makes a full dynamic comparison of all your Power BI file contents and identifies and highlights the differences. So how do these tools work? Again, the basic idea is that if you have a main report file, you use the Power BI Buddy file as a companion toolbox file for the main file. And in order to work with it and relate to what's going on in the report file, you need a connection between those files or any means of exchanging information here. And the first element you have is a live connection to the underlying SSIS tabular instance that all Power BI desktop files are running on. And therefore, you need the port ID, which can easily be retrieved through DAX Studio, for example. And the Power BI Cleaner tool also needs some input from the file, but there we cannot use a live connection. Instead, we have to transform the report file to a template file first and connect that to the cleaner file. And once we have that, we can also hook that up to the body file and retrieve some more information that's useful for the body file as well. And on top of that, to make full use of the cleaner file, you also need a set of VPAX files. These are files that can also be generated by DAX Studio, and they basically return results of DMVs in a certain format that also give additional information of what has been going on in your main report file. And last but not least, to use the Power BI Comparer, you need the template files, actually files, because you need them for your current file and for your previous version, of course, as well. So that's basically the structure of the three tools and how they connect to your current work. One live connection and unfortunately some snapshot data. So you have to, of course, regenerate the template files if you want to generate fresh information from the tools on the left side here. And with that said, I'm going to hop over to the demos. So this is the Power BI Buddy files. You have some instructions here on the first side. I haven't blogged about it yet, so because this is still a prototype. So if you want to test it out, please feel free, send me a message. You get, I'm going to show my email at the end of the session. And I'm happy to send this prototype file to you. And of course, will be interested to hear your feedback as well. So what the body file shows you is all measure dependencies on your current model in a visual way. So that can also help you if you think, well, I want to make a change in my planning measure. You can easily click on it and see which other measures depend on it and get might get a first indication whether that's a good idea or not. And the other thing is that here you will see a dynamic comparison of the differences you might have in any of your subtotals. I'm going to show an example for that in a minute. What you're also gonna see is a dynamic comparison of your model tables. So if you want to understand what has changed between your current model and your previous model, there can basically be two main reasons for it. The first reason is, has my underlying data changed? So if the data model has different refresh times and therefore probably different data, you would see that here. So here you would see which tables, raw tables from your data model have actually different content in them. And on the second page, you can see the table profile commands on these tables, and there you see some statistical information and get more insight about what has actually changed in your raw data. And another thing is that you can also send live DAX queries from your visuals and matrices in your model and compare them as well between old models. So not the underlying raw data, but what your measures actually evaluate based on that data. The outcome is then compared and only the differences are displayed in this sheet. And last but not least, you can also easily compare your measures here. Here, this is a table where you see a flag whether the measures are identical or not. So here you see some false flags and then the true flags start. We have a full text search here on all columns from this table. So if you are interested in anything, any field in your measures, for example, where they are referenced or so, you can just type that in and also see where this string is included in your measures. So that's basically just a handy tool to have at hand, I think, if working with DAX measures. But the body tool can do more. So this is just what you see on the report sheets here is just what makes sense to be displayed on a report. But the first thing I want to show you actually as a live example lives inside the query editor. And this is a feature that allows me to debug DAX variables. Let me hop over to my main report file. So this is my finance report file. And in here, I have a table that should show me the cost of goods sold as a percentage to my income. And here I see that's 100%, which doesn't make sense because I would expect something like minus 40% in here. So I want to understand what's going on, why my measure doesn't return the correct results. So I'm going to look up my measure that's called actual here. I go to my measure table and click on actual. And there I see that's quite a lot going on in my measure. I have tons of variables. And in order to understand at which stage of the variables the reason for the error might occur, I can simply copy all the DAX measure code from my report file here. And I go to my body workbook. in the folder debug variables, and here in the folder enter data, there's only one query, and in there I have to paste the copied code. Therefore, I click Control A and paste the copied code in here. That's all I have to do. And then I hop over to the result folder and I see that another DAX code has been dynamically generated by this function here. And the only thing I have to do is to copy this new DAX code and create a new measure with it in my original report workbook. So here I'm back in my workbook, and I'm creating a new measure by simply pasting the whole code that I've just copied into the as a new measure here, and it's all fine. So the dynamic generation has worked all right. And now I can drag that measure into my matrix to study row by row where the reason for the problem might lie. So I'm dragging it here, and this is a lot of text that should be formatted a bit to make it more readable. And therefore I go to WordWrap here and also here. So also the row headers WordWrap. So here I see that for my first sales revenue measure, that returns a euro result, only one variable has been evaluated and the other variables don't show any values. But my problematic value has been in a field where percentages are being shown. And there I see that the variables here, they show that the denominator and the numerator, they have both the same values due to the fact that the account selections have been identical. So this is the reason that I get my 100% here. So what I can do then is, after could identify the problem, I go back to my raw data and go and see that in the definition for my, here in row 8, in the definition for this KPI, I have the argument Cox in both fields, but here it should actually be the income. So I copy my value, paste it in here. Of course, in edit would be better in edit mode. Copy my value, paste it in here. And after the refresh, my data should be fine again. So this is just I find convenient way to see at a glance what's going on in my variables. Here I see now cost of goods sold and income, and I get my 43.8%, and everything's fine. So this is just one trick to quickly just understand what's going on. All I have to do is to copy the DAX code that has some questions in it, go to the body tool, paste it in here, and take the automatically generated DAX code back to my main workbook to see what's going on. I have an article about this method as well, so you can I'm gonna send the PowerPoint, and you can just follow the links and read more in details how to apply this method, because you can also return the results of variable tables in there. So there's quite quite some capabilities in it. But the next thing I wanted to show you is how to dynamically check subtotals. So here I just have a very small example of a table with two product groups, A and B, and for products P1 until P4. P1 has a price of 10 and we sold 5 of it, P2 8 and we sold 20 of it. So the sales on the details look all right, but the sales on the subtotals, they don't look good. And usually you don't have small tables like this, you have big tables and many, many measures. So how can you evaluate big matrices where you want to check whether these values all add up in a quick and convenient way? This is easily be done by grabbing the DAX code that lives behind this visual here. Therefore, I go to View and Performance Analyzer, start a recording and refresh the visuals on the page. And then I can click on the matrix and copy the DAX query that has been used to generate these results. And with this DAX query, I go to the body tool, and as again, under the enter data folder, there's just one query. I paste all the copied code in there. And then I go to the results and can make a quick check of my subtotals. And there I get an error. And this is because I try to, the function that's running that tries to use the live connection here to the report file. And to use it, I need the correct port ID. And here it's quite a big likelihood that I still have invalid port ID, as I just restarted my computer when I had problems with Teams. And restarting my Power BI desktop, of course, also meant that I got a new port ID. So I'm gonna have to fetch the current port ID for my report workbook. So I go to my report workbook, and here I can just select DAX Studio from my external tools. And by doing it this way, I don't have to connect manually to my model here, but I can just have the correct model connected and down to the right here. I have to open zoom it as well. Down here you see that you see localhost and then a number after it. And the 10434 of the localhost is actually the port number I have to use to connect to this model. So I go back to the body tool and enter 10434 as my port ID. And then, I go back to my query, and then I'm gonna be prompted how to connect to this localhost. And I have to use my Windows credentials as this is running on my local Windows machine here. And after I've connected, then I see that one measure, my sales measure here, this is the only measure that has whose sums don't add up. And the columns you see here are the different levels and the sums or subtotals in the different levels. So on level 4, the values add up to 530, which was the correct value. That's the detail level. But the subtotals and the totals don't, they should also show 530, but they don't. And this is flagged here by this dynamically generated table. And if I want to see this, the details for this, I can go to the next table, and there I basically see the details consolidated in the format that the DAX query usually returns like that in a flat form. So that's basically when I paste the DAX query into DAX Studio and click run here, I see the results down here in a format that's basically the same than that you see in the body tool here, just like this is all already filtered and only returns these details for the measures that are actually have problematic or differences in them. So this is what you can see here in a matrix form, here where you see the details for the checked subtotals. You see that on level 4 you had 530, 1080 and 2500. So this is just a quick check for the consistency of your DAX measures that should add up in your subtotals. And another useful check could be to compare all the results of all your visuals in your report, so your complete report, to the previous version. And so you just, if you might maybe change the measure or so, and you know that the data is identical in your previous workbook and in your current workbook, but you want to check that you didn't break any measure results, you can just record all DAX queries of your whole model, for example. In that case, let me just stop what I've recorded already and cleared. I'm going to start a new recording here. I'm going to refresh the pages I'm interested in, my main report page, my tooltips page, and also the check subtotals page. And now you see that a couple of DAX queries have been generated. And instead of copying them one by one over, I create a zip file. Here I'm going to export all the DAX queries into a JSON file. And this JSON file, the path to this JSON file now goes into my parameter here. And in order to compare it to the previous version, of course, I also need a port number for the previous version. Therefore, I have to open the workbook first. Any questions so far while I'm working, while I'm opening the other workbook?
Not yet, MK.
Okay.
Are all of these tools available on your blog site currently?
Yes, apart from the body file, all other tools are downloadable. Yeah.
Okay, you wrote the body tool, right?
Yes, yes, that's all my tools.
It's quite interesting.
Yeah. So here we have the original file. And I go back to DAX Studio, and I now have to connect to the original file in order to retrieve the port number for this workbook. And that's 10423. Go back to the body. Sometimes I hate. 10, 4, 2, 3. And this should, of course, I have to connect to the second analysis services instance as well. And there we see that out of the, out of the, let me see how many DAX queries we had. So we had 7 DAX queries in total. And out of these 7 DAX queries, 5 DAX queries led either, just 2 led to different results. 2 queries showed identical results and 1 returns an error because in my new workbook, I used a measure that has not been included in the old workbook. So this is something that we can will later identify by a measure comparison. But that's basically the first evaluation. All these DAX queries have now been fired against the new workbook. The results are in here. Against the old workbook, the results are in here if they could be evaluated. Here you see that the variable debug measure format string, that's the measure I just copied over in the first exercise here, that hasn't been included in the old file, and therefore we cannot compare the results, of course. So you get a first indication of where things are not identical. And in the second table, you see more details about it. So you see, if you go back here, you see that in the visuals income and expenses, they have been the visuals that have been had differences. And here you see the maximum values from the plan measure in both visuals. They are different in the old and in the new workbook, so you have something to look at and to further explore what the reason for it could be. And to get into the details here, you can go down to the measure comparison and go to the query compare measures, and again I have to confirm the port connections. And here you see the table that I've showed before. You see all the measures compared with each other. And here in this column, you see whether they are identical or not. And this is actually something that can then be also be seen here. You can just then try to understand what the differences were. Here my Cox percentages and my planning measure has differences in that. So this is basically an analysis of or a display of the differences in your measure definitions there. Yes, so this is what the Buddy workbook can currently do for you. And in the next demonstration, I'd like to show you what you can do with the cleaner tool. No questions? Do we have still visitors with us, or did they drop off?
Yes, we do. We have more than 50 people watching you.
Okay.
But I think they are all mesmerized with your deep technical knowledge.
I hope it wasn't too fast. I try to keep up, make up a bit time. But yeah, if there are questions, just fire them in and interrupt me. I'm happy to explain them. So this is a Power BI Cleaner tool. You find that on my blog already. Here are some instructions. A lot of the logic is taken from the Vertipack, analyzer that Marco and Alberto have developed. And in the first sheet, you see the table comparisons. Here in the left column, you see the table names and all its columns. And you see the cardinality and the size in the model. But there's a new column here called where used. And in there, you can see where each column is included in the model, whether it's included in measures or in relationships, for example, or in roles, or in visuals, of course, no, in visuals as well. So every occurrence of measures has been covered, except what's included in incremental refresh policies and calculation groups. So calculation groups is really on top of my list. As soon as I find the time, I will definitely include this as well, because they are now available for ordinary pro licenses. Of course, it would be great to have them included in this analysis as well. So basically, what you can do is, if you know that that you don't have anything in these two areas here, you can just filter on blank items here. And here you can see that you can save a lot of quite some space in your model just by deleting all these columns in here. They are not used. And other blank ones, and just take up space. So and clutter your report. So that's one idea of this analysis. And what you also can do is, if you think, well, I thought I could delete that, I wasn't aware that this column actually has been used in a measure, and which measure actually has it been used, you can then drill through to see either where it has been directly used. So this column has directly been used just in one measure called plan. But if you check, click on where used indirect as well, there you can see that the measure plan has been used in a couple of other measures as well. Here you see the measure or the depending measures. For example, plan has been used in the measure planning and also in the measure var and also in the measure var perk. So this is just, this shows you the full usage of main measures basically in sub measures as well. So also a display of measure relationships just in a different form here. And again, here you can also search for measures as well, but that's basically something that is included in the Power BI body already. So this is the main feature of the cleaner tool. Just identify what's used anywhere in your model and then clean up the columns that you don't use, you don't need anymore. So, and if there are no questions, I will then hop over to the last tool.
Okay, actually regarding comparing measures, Donald is asking you, have you used ALM toolkit for comparing measures?
No.
No.
Mm-mm.
It has nothing to do technically with the ALM toolkit.
I've not used it. I cannot. I think I opened it once and but yeah, I'm just using my tools here. And this is the comparer tool. I made it in Excel because I think it made I need the visual real estate for the comparison, and also when I do comparison for audits, for example, I can easily take some notes near the elements that actually have differences in them and explain them. So this is the reason why I used Excel for this and not Power BI for this task. The only thing you have to do is to fill in the path to your template files in the two cells over here, path to the old version and to the new version. And then you click refresh. And then you see in which area of your models there are differences. I've divided it into differences in mashups and the Power Queries themselves, differences in the model, so all the measures and columns and DAX expressions and so on, differences in visuals and everything else. So if we jump over to the mashup comparison, here you can see the query names, which group they belong to, the new query name, and all the steps in them, in the old query and also in the new query. And in yellow, you see the code that is not identical. Here I have a renamed column steps that references the previous step at quarter here. And here I have a renamed column step that references a different step or table name, the change format. And this is due to the fact that I inserted some rows in here. And of course, with a sequential, in this case, with a sequential order here, these lines of code are actually different between my two queries in here. I can also filter to see things that are only in the first or the second, or just filter deleted queries or new queries if there would have been any. But honestly, I never use these filters. I like it more this way, just to quickly scroll down and eyeball for the yellow highlighted items. And I just like to have the context around here to understand what's going on. But yeah, you can filter as well. If you have hundreds of queries, of course, you can also filter by query name and so on to see and understand what's going on.
Yeah, this might be my another favorite external tool to play with. Definitely. Looks like we will have wonderful external tools again. We are still lacking some version control system while developing Power BI models. We have one question. Can the Power BI comparer even compare the performance between the old and the new version of the file?
No.
That's a totally different thing.
Yeah, this is really this is an analysis on that material basically. So I'm analyzing. It's running based on the template file. files here. So the comparer connects to template files, and template files is just JSON. It's just a JSON code that shows the structure of my data model, and nothing more. So I cannot do that. No. And the next sheet shows the comparison between the table elements. So here I see the name of my tables, attributes, whether you see measures or columns or partitions or whatever, then the names of the attributes, the next level of the attributes, and then the full key. This is all passed dynamically. And the fullness hierarchy within the JSON file is reflected, and the first four levels basically got their own columns that you can filter on. And after that, you just see the full key that also includes more elements that might not include it in the if there are more than four levels in the hierarchy basically. And as again, you see what has been changed will be highlighted in yellow. Here we see some changed power queries that are still in there because I didn't adjust it to the new metadata format. So since with the new metadata format that we have since a couple of months, all the power queries that are loaded into the data model are also included in the code in here. So that's basically a duplication that I should clean up. But here we see that we have a new measure. It's called measure, new measure. That's hasn't been included in the old version. And yeah, so you see at a glance what's happened in the data model. And in the next sheet, you see the comparison of all elements that belong to visuals in your model. And that's usually quite big and detailed. Here, for example, we see that we have 2008 and 2009 in a field. Here you see the full key. You see how nested these elements are in the JSON string in there. And if you see here, that's the name of the visual TT. That's been this. Not the name of the visual, the name of the report sheet. That's something like that can be identified. And here you see objects, general, blah, blah, blah. Filter, where, so this is something where a filter has been changed from 2008 to 2009. And here we see that this is a tooltip that belongs to this sheet here. In my new sheet, I have 2009 filter, and in my old report, I had 2008. So you see which filter values had been changed, and also scroll down. Maybe we're gonna use a filter. On here, we see all the changed elements and also the deleted elements and new elements if there would have been any. And
one question, MK, does it also yes? work with reports that are live connected to AS?
Not yet.
Not yet, okay.
That's also on my list, but I have no clue when I will be able to include that. No, not yet.
Okay.
And then we have everything else. Here you see a lot of all the timestamps have also been recorded. This is something I usually filter out, because of course I know that these elements are different, and there you see some other metadata changes or layout changes, whether you've moved your visuals a couple of in your model. So yeah, that's basically the last tool from my toolbox.
Okay, thanks a lot, Imke. That was a hell of a session. Let me send your camera as well for the audience to see you. Do we have any further questions? Personally, I'm deeply impressed with your technical knowledge regarding Power Query, especially.
Yeah, so these tools are all made with Power Query. Uh-huh. I forgot to mention, but I thought, yeah, you got it. Yeah. Mm.
Okay. I think there is no further question. This was our last meetup this year. We hope to continue in the next year, and we hope to see you again, Imke. I'm really impressed with your knowledge, with your blog posts. It's just hardcore information, and they are even not available in the normal documentation of Power Query.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot for that.
Yeah. I just made my way to the chat, and of course I promised you that let me share my screen again to show the my email that you can get. Please feel free to send me an email if you want to test out the body tool. So I'm going to send that to you, and please have in mind that this is still development. So if you find something that doesn't make sense or you have problems with, just drop me a line, please.
Okay, I will publish the links in the recording. Maybe it will be, hopefully it will be available in the next week, I guess. Mm-hmm. Okay, looks like all of us are impressed with your knowledge, definitely. If we don't have more questions for Imke, let's wait for another minute, maybe. I would like to thank you again for the audience. Apologies. This was the first time that we had difficulties at the beginning.
Yeah, sorry about that.
Better late than never, no worries. Okay.
Thanks for your interest and patience. It was a pleasure to present this to you.
Likewise, thank you. Thanks a lot. I think we're all done.
Great.
Happy New Year to everyone.
Happy New Year.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.
Bye.